Welcome to our House of Horror.
I'm David Finoro.
I'm Sean.
I'm Nick Densmore, and this is our project on the genre of horror.
We're going to show you some awesome horror movies, some awesome cliches, repetitions, stuff we just found in horror movies. Yeah, that's about it. Hope you enjoy.
Alright, so we're going to show you some cliches often found in horror movies right now.
Cliché number one!
And the first cliché is when the character takes forever to open the door, there's tons of suspense, and it turns out to be completely non-threatening or just a nightmare.
Cliche number two, horror movies tend to try to use children to install psychological fear in most of their movies.
Cliché number three.
Alright, our third and final cliché are characters who cause large amounts of distress and are very irritating towards the main character. However, they are not the main antagonists.
Listen up. I'm going to give everybody a job to do, and I expect you to do all of it. I don't want to see any half-assing. You know what? Why don't you start off by cleaning up that mess you made in Metropolis?
The blood of human sacrifice must come. From them, the blood of expiation.
You try it. Fucking try it! Come on!
We want the boy!
The movie that our group is focusing on is The Blair Witch Project. This movie strays from traditional horror movies in a number of ways. The movie successfully scares the audience without the use of music, and it manages to be scary without ever showing the villain, and it uses minimal gore.
Alright, The Blair Witch Project was one of the earlier films to use a fake documentary approach to horror movies. At the very beginning of the film, it tells us that what we are about to watch is completely real. It says that three filmmakers entered a forest in Burkittsville, Maryland, to make a documentary on the Blair Witch, and that 1 year later their footage was found. The film then begins with its shaky cam filming and realistic storytelling. This makes the viewer feel as if what they are watching is real, and makes them feel like they are in the woods with them.
I'm scared to close my eyes. I'm scared to open them.
Unlike most horror movies, there was not a lot of written script from the movie. The actors were given an outline and had to improvise all of the dialogue. The budget was also extremely low compared to most horror movies. It was estimated at around $20,000. Blair Witch Project made over $200 million at the box office and is the second most profitable movie of all time. The first movie on our list is The Exorcist. This is a defining movie in the genre of horror. The movie is about a girl who is possessed by an evil spirit and two priests try to exorcise her despite her resistance. In this psychological horror, the demon taunts the priest's most sensitive memories and causes mayhem.
Our number 5 movie is based on a book by Stephen King, Pet Sematary. This movie is about a cemetery that is forever cursed to bring back to life whatever was buried. And when these things are revived, they become possessed and evil, and they pursue whoever buried them.
Come on, Doc. We've got places to go.
Alright, so our number 4 pick is Evil Dead 2, which is a remake and a sequel to the original movie with a slight comedic twist. The setting and plot are almost exactly the same as the first, but this movie, it's not really meant to be taken seriously, as there are scenes that are not meant to frighten the audience or highly over-exaggerate in action. The director Sam Raimi throws the audience from being terrified from one scene to laughing in the next scene. And he does this in a very effective way. Alright, for number 3 spot we've got Dawn of the Dead, which is the 1978 original, and in this movie, survivors of the zombie apocalypse hide out in a mall, trying desperately to survive the invasion. They fight as long as they can to survive and avoid being bitten at all costs. The movie also has a commentary on our society. The director, George A. Romero, uses the zombies as metaphors in order to tell us about consumerism and our culture. It is a very intelligent and revolutionary horror film, which is why it is at our number 3 slot. This movie also spawned a very successful remake in the early 2000s.
When there's no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth.
Halloween is a movie where the audience is constantly paranoid about killer Michael Myers appearing. Michael always sneaks up on his victims and never stays down when he is hurt. Michael walks very slowly, which creates a sense of panic in the viewer.
Number 1 on our list is The Shining, also based on the Stephen King novel. The movie takes place in a hotel that slowly possesses the main character, Jack. The hotel slowly begins to reveal more and more illusions that leaves the viewer wondering what is real. By the end of the movie, Jack is so consumed by evil that he tries to kill his own family.
Here's Johnny!